The Riddles of Barabbas, Chapter 2, The Parable of Pride. Jesus Barabbas visits Cana, then Jerusalem, while Jesus of Bethlehem wanders in the wilderness near Galilee. Both Jesus were led by the Spirit out to the wilderness tempted by serpent. Jesus Bethlehem could never be tempted, but Jesus Barabbas, he rushed to the spoils. Bethlehem first tempted by stones into bread, shook his head no, quoted scripture, and said, "These stones are just fine to stay still in their bed. I don't just need food, but God's words for my head." Barabbas need not hear the voice of the serpent. His mother was there wanting water to repent. Its form was not good enough for her to own. She had no more use for it than bread from stone. Reluctantly, Jesus went through with the trick, and servants poured wine from great barrels so thick. If truly a miracle they saw that day, near 200 gallons of water's at play. How much of this wine was drained into the sink, since all of the guests had had too much to drink? The nobles and masses, with brawlers and revelers, stayed up through the night or passed out in their cellars. They drank until vomit from their stomachs burst, while people of common birth were parched with thirst. Bethlehem was next tempted, jump off a cliff. Said Satan, "No worries, you're safe in a jiff. The devil, quotes scripture, says angels will come, lift up in their hands so your foot won't strike stone." Bethlehem says wisely, "I'll have none of this, for scripture says also God's will not to test." Barabbas, meanwhile, has gone to Jerusalem, made whips out of cords to chase out all of them. Sheep, cattle, and dove sellers, facing his zeal, asked, "Why in the world would you make this appeal? We make a good profit from selling atonement. Your anger is not quite enough to convince us." But Jabar did not mention any of that. His problem was simply they sold this and that. To demonstrate why he thought markets were trouble, he said, "Take this temple, reduce it to rubble. If you do this now, then I'll prove to you then, in 3 days I'll build this place over again." The stampede of cattle, doves fluttering around, the coins of all cultures a mess on the ground, this madman demanding the temple steamrollered, only one conclusion, it's type 2 bipolar. The priests at the temple took him to the ground, kept him somewhere till his mind was more sound. For 3 days they kept his feet from striking ground and let him out healthy, unhurt, and unbound. He came out and said, "I've been dead for 3 days. You see how I meant. Don't try thinking your ways. Believe in my name and your faith. It will do. Define what I say to mean something that's true." Jabez was next tempted with all the world's wealth. The devil said, "You need not take it by stealth. All this is yours at a very low price. For worshipping, you'll get more value than lice." But Jesus could tell what the serpent had offered. A world of no love, with wealth clotted in coffers. But Jesus would not preach the gospel of cynics, to say all are sinful, right to their appendix, to profit off guilt and self-doubt like the devil, to claim man was made not from good but from evil. God did not err, people shouldn't feel lonely. Worship the good Lord God, serving him only. The devil came also to Jabar that day. "Your name is believed, now you'll have your own way." Barabbas, though, didn't need any more coaching, because his contempt was all ready for boasting. No masons, no smiths, and no poets, no artists. I trust none of them, for I know where their heart is.